Hello everyone, how are you all? Today our topic is carotenoids. So what is carotenoids? Today we will discuss in this particular topic. So carotenoids. So when you are in a local market, so do you stop to notice the variety of the colors and the fruit and vegetables around you? I think everyone does. So from the vibrant orange and yellow peppers to deep red tomatoes and the dark leafy greens vegetables, it means the colors are everywhere. So these pigments are only groups are only called as a carotenoids. Now if you are new on my channel, so please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon to get the latest update of my channel. In this particular lesson, today we will discuss that what is carotenoid, that the type and what is the need of carotenoids, supplements and the biosynthesis of terpenoids. So firstly we will see the introduction of isoprenoid molecule. Isoprenoid molecules, if you don't know about the isoprenoid molecule, so you can see my the last video which I have posted earlier. So they are the family of isoprenoid molecules which are widespread in the nature. These are the fat soluble pigments. Fat soluble pigment means those which are broken down in the presence of fat only. So either you love fruits and vegetable or not, but you have consumed many foods which contains a carotenoids only. Okay, so here now we will see the types of carotenoids. So what are the types of carotenoids which are present around us? So there are only two types. That one, first one is carotene and the next one is a xanthin. So carotenes and other carotenoids are found in the members of the plastids and the double membrane bound organelles. While this one xanthophylls, they are the yellow pigments and the present in mostly highest quantity in the leaf where they modulate the light energy. Mainly these carotenoids are the responsible for the various colors of the plant, leaves and the fruits. Now we will see regarding the xanthophyll in detail. What is xanthophyll? These are the yellow pigments that leaves and classified as a accessory pigments. They absorb the wavelength that chlorophyll cannot absorb. So they serve as a protection to excessive amount of a sunlight to prevent further damage in the plant. And this one lutein and xanthin are fall under this one xanthophyll category only. Okay, so these are three types: canthaxanthin, zeaxanthin and lutein. The examples are these ones: spinach, squash, pumpkin, mangoes, papaya and sweet potatoes. Now come to the carotene. What is carotene? These are orange photosynthetic pigments which are found in the plant and plays an important role in the photosynthesis. They transmit the light energy and that they absorb from the chlorophyll only. They have a significant role in helping the plants grow. The examples are beta carotene and lycopene fall under this category of carotenoids only. Next one, why do we need carotenoids? Everyone having question like this, why should we eat this one carotenoids? Because the diet high in carotenoids, fruits and vegetables are associated with the reduced risk of serious diseases and some cancer and the chronic diseases also. I think in this coronavirus season, everyone is taking this one oranges also, orange especially, and another thing is lemon, because the both contains this one carotenoid that having a yellow pigment, right? So everyone, you all have to take this one orange also and the lemon also, and most because they having also use in as a immune system booster. So now next thing, this one is a pathway or biosynthesis of our carotenoids. So this pathway starts from the mevalonic acid. This mevalonic acid, it may be converted into a xeranyl diphosphate, phytoene, then lycopene, which is found in our tomato also, and the beta carotene, which is found in our carrots and xanthophyll. Now, the importance of this one, this help in the assimilation, protection for the sensitizing enzyme in the cell, help in the reproduction of the algae and as an antioxidant. Now here you will see what is this one, right? So this one is nothing like that. There are the two things which we can use as a carotenoid supplements if you're not taking carotenoids in your diet. Okay, so the first one is a Macu Health with LMZ3. What is this one, Macu Health? This is the only dietary supplement that contains all three critical carotenoids. That one is lutein, also zeaxanthin, mesozeaxanthin. Okay, and in the macular pigment of the eye, according to the about WHO, etc. Next one, this one is the eye promise zeaxanthin plus lutein. This one is designed to increase the macular pigment optical density and protect the macular photoreceptor with the highest available level of a dietary zeaxanthin. Now, how do I know if I need a carotenoid supplement? So only your doctor can evaluate the amount of macular pigment in your eyes by performing a simple evaluation which is called as a MPOD, means macular pigment optical density. Okay, so this one was under the would, now you can say that what is this one, macular, etc. So the most sensitive part of our retina in the eye, that one is called as macula. This macula has the highest concentration of photoreceptor in the retina and is the portion of the retina where our sharpest vision is produced. So it is also responsible for our ability to perceive colors. Okay, so now, not but the last, remember, whenever your parents told you to eat carrots so you would have a good eyesight, at the time please don't consider that this was a trick to get you eat that particularly vegetables, because you should know now very well that what is the rule of these one carrots, because this having a role in the vitamin A also for your body, immune system, everything. So now you all have to take this all types of carotenoids. So thank you. Hopefully you like my video. If you like, please subscribe and share.